Hey robot makers, do you want to know about the new Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect? Then keep watching. So this new board is absolutely jam-packed full of stuff. We have a microphone on there, we have an IMU motion detection accelerometer gyrometer, we have an RP2040 chip from Raspberry Pi organization, we have an authentication chip, we also have 16 megs of additional memory, we have Bluetooth and Wi-Fi all in one tiny little package. Now at the moment, the chip only really works with C++, or the embed OS, which is what Arduino put a lot of effort behind. So they've created an entire ecosystem from the IDE, there's a cloud-based service, and now with the Wi-Fi, this means we can create devices that can connect to sensors and then publish that data up to the cloud, where we can then put dashboards and widgets and all that kind of thing, very similar to what we've looked at with Node-RED. So currently the MicroPython support on this chip is very minimal, so we can just do the things that we can do with a regular Raspberry Pi Pico, so we can't do things like connect to the Bluetooth or the Wi-Fi or the IMU or any of the other things like the microphone. So it's a little bit crippled at the moment, but I guess that's going to come in time. So over here we've got a diagram that shows you all the different components of the system. So right in the middle there we've got the RP2040 chip. That's the main brains of this Arduino chip. However, it actually has a second processor. So the U-Blocks Nina chip, which is the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth chip, that also controls the RGB LED that's on board. It's kind of like a mini Neopixel. That also has its own processor. So we can actually code both of these separately. On the left-hand side of the diagram there, we have the microphone. So that's a MEMS microphone. On the right-hand side, we have the 16 meg of additional flash memory. So that means we've got absolutely vast amounts of space to store additional scripts. Then on the bottom row, we have the authenticator. This is very similar to the Apple Secure Enclave. So we can store tokens and things like that within this authenticator chip. And then we have the IMU, which has a 6-axis gyroscope and accelerometer. And we also have the regulator at the very top, which just drops down the 5 volts to 3.3 volts throughout the rest of the chip. So let's have a look at some of the pinouts. This is also available as a downloadable PDF from my buymeacoffee.com site, if you want to have a similar kind of poster to the rest of the posters that I've already created. So if we look there, we have all the different pins. There is 30 pins on this chip altogether. And we can see there is a number of GPIOs, and these are just regular pins from a MicroPython perspective. So we have transmit and receive, similar to the Arduino on pin 0, pin 1. And then we have some of the analog pins over on the other side there from pins 26 to 19, or digital pins 21 to digital 14. You can see also there that we have some reset pins and we have some ground pins and a couple of 5 and 3.3 volts. The board also has three LEDs on board. So there's a power LED, there's a built-in LED, and there is also that NeoPixel as well. So this board is built on the Raspberry Pi silicon, which is similar to the Raspberry Pi Pico. So it's a dual core ARM Cortex M0 Plus running at 133 megahertz. It's got 264K of RAM on board. So this slide I showed you a couple of months ago, back in January when the original Raspberry Pi Pico was launched, and you can see there it said there was support for 16 meg of off-chip flash RAM. And that's exactly what Arduino have done here. They brought in that extra RAM so that we can store things on there. And the rest of the spec is the same as the Raspberry Pi Pico, or as the Pi Moroni Tiny 2040, or one of the Adafruit Feather chips. So Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connectivity. So U-Blocks have provided this new Nina module. This is from a family of chips that they have, that they provide for Wi-Fi, for radio, for Bluetooth connectivity. So it's Bluetooth 5.0 and Wi-Fi as well. And it also includes this dual core extensor LX6 CPU. And that can be independently programmed. So think about that. We've got two processor chips on board. We can do some clever things with that. So one of the cool things that they provided as part of the documentation is an interactive schema. So we can actually look at some of the components on there by using this web page. So we can zoom in there, we can see what the pinouts are, we can see all the different components that are in there. So there's one of the chips. So there, for example, is the 3D accelerometer and 3D gyroscope. We can see all the different pins and pinouts that it has. And we can see the microphone there, for example. And over here, we can see the built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth as well. So that's the interactive schema. And what we can do is we can click on one of those things and we can actually see where that is on the board as well. So there's a PCB board there. We can actually look at each of the chips and see where that is on the schema. And there's also a 3D model as well, so we can have a look in 3D what this looks like. So pretty cool that they've included this on the documentation. So the Arduino organisation have really upped their game with the documentation. So if we head over there to docs.arduino.cc, we can see there that they've got this new hardware tab and they have lots of documentation. So if I scroll down there to the Nano RP2040 Connect, I can then see there's a quick start guide, there's a data sheet I can download, there's some essentials which talks you through all the different components. So there's going to be a lot of documentation, I'm afraid, with this one because there are so many moving parts with it. There is all kinds of things like the three-axis gyroscope and accelerometer. There is the pulse density modulation, which is the microphone. There is the Wi-Fi Nina, which is all the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth code. And then we've got all the regular kind of Arduino stuff as well on there. But they have got some tutorials. So we can see there, there's some tutorials about how to create like a web server, how to set up a connect with the IoT cloud, how to read microphone data so you can detect things like somebody knocking. And you can also do things like control the RGB LED over Wi-Fi through the Connect. So I've not had much time to experiment around with this. I was trying to see what the MicroPython support was like, because obviously that's something I'm really interested in for my projects. So I hope you found this video quite useful. It was just a bit of a taster to see what this new chip is like and what we can do with it. And I'm sure I'll be adding this to some of my projects in the future, particularly when they've updated the Wi-Fi and the Bluetooth support as well. See you next time.